Do job titles matter? Well, how do they matter in comparison to the actual experience you have? So today we are going to talk about how your job title matters and the one danger when we put a little too much weight on that job title. Now, if we haven't met, my name is Cassandra and I help motivated professionals build their careers through practical tips to gain career confidence. And today we gotta talk all about that job title. So yes, overall, your job title matters. And we're going to talk about why and how, but also at the end, I'm going to share with you one big caveat around that job title. So first, and this is going to sound obvious, but it needs to be said, I've made mistakes around it. Your job title should be showcasing to people the level you're working at and what you do, obviously. But your job title, you want to make sure it's hitting what would be industry standard. So I will be honest, early on in my career, I didn't care enough about title. I was just happy with the work I was doing and didn't realize that the title I had made me look like a much smaller or lower role in kind of the hierarchy than what I actually did. So the title said coordinator, but my job, if I had gone somewhere else, actually was two different producer level roles. So I had the title contestant coordinator, but that did not do justice to what I did. If you looked at my actual bullet points, and once I left one show and went to other shows, I discovered that, wait, what I did of auditioning the contestants and then casting and producing them day of, those were two different roles and both were producer titles. Casting producer, and I think it was just like a segment producer or game show producer, depending on what show you were on, if you produced day of show. But I didn't care enough about title, and I really should have, because that was something that made it really hard when I moved to other jobs to explain to them. So make sure your title is matching what you actually do. And if right now you're having a wake-up call and you're like, oh, it doesn't, set a meeting with your supervisor. Just have a discussion, right? We don't demand anything, but have a discussion and talk about how do we get this title moved over to what, so that it reflects what I'm actually doing. And in the years since I had that job, I will admit I have changed my title on LinkedIn, on resumes in certain situations, just so that it's not confusing the person on the other end, right? I'm not trying to lie about anything. I'm not pulling the wool over anyone's eyes. I know it's a slightly controversial thing to say, but I do think there are times where you change your title to make it clearer what you actually did for the person to understand. Now, if you are not a manager, we're not calling ourselves a manager, right? If we didn't manage people in some way, well, then you're not a manager on certain teams. But for example, there's also the trend of giving like fun titles. Now, I feel like this is finally going away, but for some years there, people got titles like Chief Officer of Fun or Chaos Coordinator. It's like nobody's searching for that and no one knows what that does. So change those titles to things that are plain spoken that people understand, like office manager. You are not the chief officer of fun, you are the corporate event planner, okay? So like, keep those things in mind. Titles do matter because they reflect to people what you do. Plus, your title matters a lot to outside stakeholders. So your title is identifying to people outside the organization what you do, be that customers, constituents. In my case, at my grad program, we all had assistantships or apprenticeships as part of our grad program. And in other departments, the grad student would just be called a graduate assistant. For my department, I had the title of program coordinator. Now, I did the work of a coordinator. My boss told me, we made it, like I fought with the grad program to have the title coordinator because you have to work with parents. And if your title says graduate assistant, they're not going to take you seriously and they're going to continue to want to come to the supervisor or the director. And so putting that title helps you have authority that they will listen to you, right? So titles matter because they help other people outside identify who you are and have authority. Now, titles also matter because hopefully they are showing a progression within an industry, right? This is partly why it was a problem that I didn't care enough about my title in the beginning. I was getting great experience, but my title wasn't progressing, even though I was doing things at a higher level. You want to make sure your title is showing a progression within your industry. You've moved from assistant to coordinator to an assistant or associate position to a manager, to right? Every industry is going to have different levels, but it shows a progression in the industry. But here's the big issue, and I've seen this a lot. You do not want to fluff up a title, and you never want to have a title that doesn't come with experience to back it up. But also, what really gets hard is sometimes companies will give you a title change, but they'll give you no promotion of experience to go with it. And it's like, well, what do I put on my resume? Or I had a boss, small company, really like three of us small, when I was first starting out, that I was assistant to the manager, and then my boss made me assistant manager. But nothing in what I did changed, and for moving into the industry, it actually made me seem like a much higher level than I was, and I didn't have the experience to go with it. So I actually switched my resume back to assistant to the manager so people wouldn't be confused, because assistant manager made it seem like I was way higher in this career trajectory than I actually was. So you don't want to have the title without the experience. Friends and I were talking about this the other day. In higher ed, this comes up all the time because there are certain institutions where everyone in a department is an assistant director. Everyone. Like my role as a career coach at one school, at a small school, could be assistant director, even though I was over nobody. And like that assistant director there and the assistant director of my state university of 30,000 students, very different in what they did. And so you just want to be careful that if you have a title, there are experiences to back up why you have that title. So today's video is really just to be kind of informative, to make you aware of some of these issues around title, why they matter, why you should be paying attention to it, but also why you should be paying attention to the experience that goes along with the title. So this is just a bit more of an informative video to get you thinking about that with titles, especially if we're looking at making career changes. What would have been a VP in one company might be an AVP in a different company or industry, right? So you need to be looking at those titles along with the experience to see where you're a good fit. So that is it for today. Just an informative little video for you. Hope this helped, and I will see you in the next one. Bye.